Welcome to Skip E Lowe Looks at Hollywood. Joining Skip will be Tim Rooney and Mickey Rooney Jr., sons of the world-famous entertainer Mickey Rooney. We hope you'll enjoy the show, and now, the man of the half hour, Mr. Skip E. Lowe.
Yay!
Tim! Oh,
hey!
Hey, look at this.
Skippy, how are you?
Two great, great performers themselves.
Thank you,
Mickey Rooney Jr. worked Vegas a lot. I mean, Sam,
I did.
You do
I did.
Country and Western.
Yes, I do.
And Tim, tell me, you're a performer, a great actor, too. You do a lot of television work.
Yeah, I do.
Tell me something. I got to ask you two guys real quick.
Okay.
Who was the favorite stepmother of all yours? How many stepmothers did he have?
Wait a minute. How would you like to be at our house on Mother's Day, Skippy? Did you ever think of that?
No. How many? Yeah, go ahead.
Well,
who was your favorite of all of them?
Well, we're from the same mother, so
right.
If I can speak for both
Miss
of us.
Miss Alabama, matter of fact. Miss Alabama.
No, that's our mother. All of the ladies that Dad has married are great ladies. The ones that are still surviving is, you know, we lost his Martha Vickers, who herself was a
lovely actress.
Lovely
lady.
If I could interject, was back then Betty Jane Race when she married my dad. She was Miss Alabama, 1944, in the Miss America contest.
You were the first child.
I'm the first born.
He's the one.
I'm the guy.
How many kids does Mickey Rooney have?
Well, let's see. Can I describe the family?
Yeah, you go. You got it better.
There's Mickey Jr. is about 6'3", and then there's yours truly. I'm Tim.
Uh-huh.
And then there's our brother Teddy, and then Kelly, Carrie, Kyle, Kimmy Sue, Jimmy, uh-huh. Jonelle, uh-huh. and then Dad.
Uh-huh.
Were you counting? Was anyone
Look,
counting?
Look, it's like this. It's just like the Musketeers.
Oh, no.
Hey. There it is.
That's it. That's you, Mickey Jr. and
Timmy.
Timmy.
Let me see that. Good oh, yeah, that God. Was at the reunion.
The reunion?
There's Mickey and there's me.
Yeah.
Tell me about those days you guys were in that club, the Mickey Mouse Club.
Yeah, I mean, it was... It was a very interesting thing because our mother had just married our first stepfather after Dad and Mom got divorced, and his name is Buddy Baker.
Uh-huh.
Buddy Baker then was the head of the music department at Walt Disney's back in 54, 55 at that time. And because of his involvement, naturally, we got in the door. It was kind of a political end, but...
What do you mean by political door? Well, because you're Mickey Rooney's sons, is that it?
You know, no, that doesn't work that way.
No.
It doesn't work that way, Skippy, because, you know, a lot of people think that it will. The name will open some doors.
It did open some doors.
Come on, let's face it.
Of course.
But at that time, I think, what
our stepfather?
I was seven, he was eight years old. I mean, you're kids, you know?
Right, right.
And Buddy, at that time... wasn't the head of the music department because it was much younger back in the 50s, but one of the head, he went on to be one of the top composers there with Bill Walsh. And of course, he and Roy and Walt, they were all there at the studio in Buena Vista. And at that time, I was seven, six, seven, 8 years old, and we were doing little theater things here and there and little guest shots on. Oh my goodness! The Doy O'Dell show and all of those little shows. And we were kids, and we were taking dancing and singing lessons. We were taking dancing lessons from Millie O'Connor, who was Donald's. Was that Donald O'Connor's sister, Mickey? Okay, and we were taking tap dancing, and we were pretty damn good too. And so the next thing you know, Mom comes home and says, "Hey, there's something happening at the studio called the Mickey Mouse Club." And so we were there, and we auditioned, and we went through the whole thing. We didn't last too long. I mean, they were changing every. The first couple of years of that show, Skippy, these kids were being changed and shuttled and everything. But it was a real foundation. The happiest moment of my life was shaking hands with Mr. Disney. I mean, how many times can you say in your life you shook hands of famous people?
Right? And being a Mouseketeer, it was the number one show of the whole year at that particular time. It went on for a couple, 3 years in a row, number one show.
Was it difficult for you guys to live with a super personality like Mickey Rooney?
No.
Growing up,
we didn't
live with him. You treated him like Dad. I mean, he was your dad.
But we didn't live with him.
No, you didn't live with him?
Oh. You know, we're raised in Glendale, California.
Okay.
Just a hop, skip, and a post-nasal drip from here.
Uh-huh.
And about 22 years. And I think that our mom did a beautiful job raising us.
Miss Alabama.
Miss Alabama. I went to and graduated Glendale High, which was a public school. Uh-huh. We both attended Hollywood Professional School in our...
HPS?
Yeah, uh-huh. HPS.
Right on Western Avenue, off of Western Avenue.
Right here.
Hey, I am a graduate.
Okay.
Yeah, that's a great school. I love that
and
school.
And so we're both in the business and doing our thing. And to answer your question, I didn't have any problem with it because later on when we got 16, 17 years old, we got closer to Dad. We said,
is that
hey.
When you really got close to your father when you were older? Mick?
No, I'll reiterate what we were just talking about. Timmy probably didn't have the kind of a problem that I did. Oh, I did have problems. I had problems right
from
the
beginning. Well, he had the name.
I wore the name.
Mickey Rooney Jr.
Yeah, wow. that's a...
The whole name.
Yeah. So give me an example, one of your problems. What?
Well, I can remember just trying to go to have a formal education in the 6th and 7th and 8th grade in a public school in Glendale. Where we were living.
Yeah, I went to public school, and Mickey, since we're brothers, we're close, and he said, let's go to public school. We've been in private school. Let's go to public schools and get with the people, you know, and
yeah,
see what this is like. And he went to Woodrow Wilson at that time, and I was in Glendale, so we went to different schools there. So he did have, you know.
But I got all the ridicule and all the bombastic stuff laid on me because of my name only. The name... back in 56 and 57 was not real fashionable to be Mickey Rooney Jr. in Glendale High School.
You see, Skippy, if you wear it as a cross, you know, or an albatross around your neck, or, you know, you bear this burden, then I guess it can be sort of a hassle. But usually we like to meet people and not, I say I'm Tim and this is Mick, or, you know, and because the minute you hear Rooney, now he can't hide from it. I mean, he's got to say,
he's
hi, I'm Mickey Rooney Jr.
Yeah.
You know,
uh-huh.
and I'm the Queen of France, you know.
Uh-huh.
Do you used to go on a set when you were kids at MGM Studios? Do you remember those wonderful days?
Yes, we did.
Mm-hmm.
And
you met Judy Garland.
Mm-hmm.
That's wonderful people.
Yep.
I met Judy when I was 13 years old. I was old enough to remember the actual meeting, and it was one of the classic meetings in my life. I was invited by Dad to go to a party. And we went to a Hollywood party, and Steve Allen was playing piano all night, and Jane was there, and Jack Carter was there, Mel Torme was there. Mm-hmm. It was just one of those kind of things. It was just glorious.
Uh-huh.
And to be 13 and to remember Judy saying, gee, walking over to me and going, gee, Mickey Jr., it's so wonderful to meet you, and could I talk to you? And I just went, whoa. And I remember going into her little library, her little study in her house, and we sat and had a one-on-one conversation like we're doing right now, but just the two of us in her study for about 15 minutes, 15 full minutes.
That was great, but I shot pool with George Harrison of the Beatles.
Yeah, that's true.
How was that?
We can't tell everything.
How did that happen, Tim?
Oh, it was
shooting
great.
Shooting pool with George.
Oh. Okay.
How did that all happen?
I got to tell you, Skippy, I don't want to be premature here, but I got to tell you this. I think I told you the other night at the party, or maybe on the phone, that we're so happy to be doing a series. We're doing a pilot for our show called The Best Kept Secrets in Hollywood.
Nice segue.
Hey.
Yeah. And The Best Kept Secrets in Hollywood, and we're real excited about it. And And
it's going to be a talk show and varieties?
No, it's going to be a variety show.
Uh-huh.
You know, the best kept secrets in Hollywood, the next one might be the best kept secrets in Washington. So,
okay.
You know, I mean, we're going to go all over this.
Uh-huh.
Now, we want to follow through with that, the best kept secrets.
Uh-huh.
And we could be the best kept secret of someone who is terribly talented.
Yes.
Someone who has a secret that they want to tell. These are going to be good things. So it's going to be a variety showcase.
Uh-huh.
Hopefully very entertaining
very
show.
Good.
Getting back to this, we have up to now lived very colorful lives, as you might well imagine, having a father like that. I mean, we've been able to meet so many people. Just briefly, I'll tell you about the back in the days when George Harrison had just released, I think, My Sweet Lord, and those, I don't remember the year, maybe it was 1970, 71, I don't know. But I was going with a girl, and went with a lovely gal named Casey Quine, whose father was the fabulous director.
Richard Quine.
So I was going with Casey. And one day we were there, and he had this gorgeous home that Ingrid Bergman had built. It was just absolutely fabulous. And we had a beautiful pool room. And one day, George Harrison walks in. And I said, "Hi, how are you doing?" And he says, "We came to look at the house. I think they were going to rent it or something." And he says, "Oh, you play pool?" I said, "Yeah." So we played a game of pool.
Well, that's real great, Timmy, but I met Elvis Presley in the middle of the road.
Tell me, Evan, this is you.
We can't give away all the
No.
I love this picture of Mickey Rooney Jr. When was this taken, Mickey Rooney?
I think, Skip, I think that was about when I was about three or something.
Because you're the oldest. And when did you come?
I was born in 47. Skippy.
Year and a half later.
When we just talked on the phone, Mickey, I told you about the picture of that. There was a picture. I got my phone rings. Like, did you see the People magazine thing? Where are they today? They show a shot of Mickey Jr. And Dad walking as he's a toddler by the pool. And immediately, when I saw the thing, and it said Mickey Rooney and his son Timmy. And I said, "Wait a minute."
No.
I mean, how can you? Yeah, right. So I mean, it can be confusion.
Tell me about your dad. I mean, he always gets into chickens, open businesses.
Gets into chickens.
Barbecues. Remember the Starbucue he had off of Hollywood Boulevard?
Certainly did, on Wilcox, where Judy Canova used to take me. And I used to go in there and get her favorite barbecue.
Okay, I'll tell you.
Tell me about that. Why is he always adventuring?
I'll tell you. Do you know who, until of late, Hank Aaron? Do you know who the home run king of the world used to be before Hank Aaron?
No.
Does the name Babe Ruth mean anything to you?
Oh, of course.
Okay.
Of course. Of course.
Who was the strikeout king?
Babe Ruth.
My point is, Skippy, as long as you're up to bat and you keep hitting, you're going to hit one out of the park sooner or later.
I see.
So
that's
if it's not the weenie whirl or the bagel chicken or Mickey Rooney's macaroni or if this is now I don't know if you've tried the TCBY yogurt, which incidentally is the country's best yogurt. It is, and this is bigger than I mean, they're
it's doing well, huh?
Yeah, well, there's 525 nationally open now, and they're gearing up for 2,200 stores. It's a national franchise, so that's doing very well. He likes it. Someone says, "Oh, Mickey, you're going to retire." No,
he's so busy. But do you know something? Sure, babes, brought him back to life again, gentlemen. Tell me.
Thank you, Ruth Webb.
Ruth Webb. Yes. She did it.
Okay. Oh, but Skippy, I don't want to say.
His talent did it, but she.
I don't want to preempt anything on your wonderful show, but this could be a whole nother show. We could do a series on this.
Okay.
When Dad and I, when he was in New York, and he started doing dinner theater, and he'll tell you, he'd be the first to tell you, this is not me talking. This is my father's words. I'm just paraphrasing what he said. He was a famous has-been. I mean, everybody could walk down the road, "Oh, there's Mickey Rooney."
Right.
But they don't know whether he's dead broke or whether he's got $1 million. Right. They don't know. But you see, my father's a true artist, and he's like Picasso was.
Certainly is.
If he painted and he needs something, he said, "Here, you like it? Give me $2. Or if you like it and you can, give me $100,000.
Yes. Yeah.
It doesn't matter whether he was making X amount of dollars doing dinner theater. If he couldn't do it, he would go into a parking lot and do 20 minutes.
Yes.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So he was kind of seething, trying to get out his artistic thing. So when Ruth and he formed an alliance about 16 years ago in New York, she took him right up through the dinner
circuit,
right there, and
to Sugar Babies came.
To Sugar Babies, and when Sugar Babies came, it was 7 years.
Now, lest we forget. Black Stallion and the motion pictures that came along that got the award nominations and that were really before Sugar Babes.
Of course. Mickey Rooney Jr., let me explain to you. Your dad happens to be one of America's great dramatic actors.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Not just a personality, but a dramatic actor.
Hallelujah.
Believe me when I say this.
Absolutely.
And I adore him because he knows the business backwards and he has every right to be mad at Hollywood, because Hollywood is not Hollywood like it used to be when your dad was an artist at MGM or any of that. Because it's changed. Am I right, gentlemen?
Yeah,
you
very,
grew up in this town.
Yeah. We're very right. We're very close to Dad's outlook on it, and the fact that he was part of what made this whole business. He does have the right
Yes, he does have the right to get up there. Yeah, I agree. May I say something? Was it difficult living with your dad at the time when he was, like you say, has been? He'll never be a has been.
No, my
Tim, he never was. But it's the same.
I know.
Was it difficult before Sugar Babies came along? Was it difficult those days?
We went through a lot of difficult times with Dad.
Like
we
what?
We went through,
when his fifth wife was tragically murdered,
yes.
And, in 66, which is, you know, my father, Skippy, is basically a very leprechaunian person.
Yes.
He is so happy. The innate light in him that shines in him sometimes can be squelched, but not for all times. He always pops back. That's right. So we went through, some very difficult times, but that's life, Skippy. Uh-huh. That's life. And you learn from it.
And you're married.
I'm very happily married, have been for 5 years. Uh-huh. And
I'm newly married.
And you're newly married.
7 months to my lovely wife, Laura.
7 months. Any kids? I just had to check
that. Isn't that funny? Yes. Well, this is Hollywood, folks.
Yeah, right.
We may have one in the oven as we speak.
Oh, okay.
So you never know.
So I like the idea your guys are going to form a show together.
Have our own variety show.
Hey, yeah. Why not? Yeah, who could do it better than
the best kept secrets in Hollywood? And then, as I say, the next one will be in Washington. This is we've got a political year coming up. And it's very important for people to get out and vote. I mean, we don't want to get into politics.
No.
But it is a political year.
What does your dad think about? He's religion now. He's into this very.
He's
new
not into religion.
He no,
was,
he's newborn.
He was always
always religious.
Newborn, yeah. Mm-hmm. My father. We are born again Christians.
We are.
And Christianity has of late gotten so much publicity about what's happening.
Well, the holy wars that are happening.
With some major televangelists that everyone knows who we're speaking about, that you know, a lot of people don't realize that there are people in every phase, whether it's your religion, whether it's your work, what you believe in, there's going to be things that happen, these things will all resolve themselves. Getting back to your question, he loves the Lord. He falls short. He's the first one to admit his shortcomings, trying to live a Christian life. But he doesn't. I wouldn't say he's a fanatic.
Yeah, I
wouldn't classify my father as a quote unquote Jesus freak. Someone who
people take Dad wrong because the world has known Mickey Rooney as one type of a picture. It's either the Andy Hardy picture or the Mickey Maguire pictures, or now the Bill. Forever in 1980s, kids
brilliant.
Will grow up remembering
brilliant.
Bill.
Bravo, Bill.
Okay.
Oh,
Bravo.
And I got a
love that.
I got a secret about that
yeah,
show.
Tell me about that
You'll
show.
You'll love this one.
I love that show.
Okay, Bill, where he played the retarded Bill Sactor. We show up to the set the first day of shooting principal photography, and they're blocking out a scene and rehearsing. Said, Mickey, let's do it. So he goes on, and he starts to portray the man like we all saw him.
Jackie Cooper directed that.
Leave Them Laughing.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No.
Excuse me.
Okay. Jackie Gleason just passed away.
I know.
Oh.
I want to dedicate this show to three great performers before
Fred Astaire.
Yeah. Fred Astaire, greatest dancer ever.
Yeah.
Geraldine Page, greatest dramatic actress ever, America.
Oh.
And the greatest comedian, actor ever, Jackie Gleason. We lost three, one after
There's
another.
Three in the
and world. I got to say, Skippy, just for your audience, for everyone who's watching right now, regardless, and change is good, and my father is opinionated, and he's got all those things, but I'm telling you, we get together, we'll listen to what he says, and my God, one of the most frequently asked questions is, how old's your dad? How old is he?
I'll never ask.
85? Is he 85? No, wait a minute.
Yeah.
It's that I say, he doesn't care, he'll be 67 in September, and that's not why, but he doesn't care about people knowing how old he is because he's eternally young, except that people think of, I say, this is 1987. He was born in 1920.
Oh my God, they didn't even have talking pictures in 1920. Right. He was starting out in pictures when he was 2 years old. He has literally grown up and given his life to the business. So on that, in that respect, he can come out against whoever he wants or for whoever he wants, the Screen Actors Guild, the union, but all change is good, it's good to talk about it.
Yes.
I may not agree with everything he says, but I know that he knows how it was before and how it is now. But I'm here to tell you, I said all of that to say this. People, Hollywood is not dead.
It's not dead.
It is not dead. Oh. It's changed. If you want to get, it's like anyone else. You can succeed. Look, if you want your own show, it's called Do Your Own Thing.
It's not a system no more.
It's not a system anymore.
Not anymore. It's only you to do it.
Right. Exactly. You got to make your own vehicle,
yes.
And you got to step out.
Yeah.
And nobody is gonna. I got to tell you, Liza Minnelli. Oh, wait a minute. I don't want to confuse your
audience. Go ahead.
I want to tell you about Bill.
Excuse me, Nick.
This is going to be a great show when I watch
it.
Hey,
Mickey.
Let me tell you this.
I got to let that.
We were talking about Bill. I thought this was classic.
Yes.
The director said, Mickey, you can't portray him like that.
Uh huh.
And Dan said, I beg your pardon. He says, you can't put that to him like that.
Uh-huh.
He said, we can't get this on the air. We'll never get it on the air.
Mm-hmm.
Dad said, look, here, you take the script. You do it.
Yeah.
He says, you do it. Thanks for thinking of me.
Uh-huh.
I don't even want the money. Just thanks for hiring me. I'm an actor.
Uh-huh.
This is the way I got to do it.
Of course.
Well, there was a big commotion. And so help me God, this is the truth. The producers and Dad, they said, my God, we can't let him walk off the set. What's going on? You know? Mm-hmm. He says, look, Mickey, we got the solution. We'll do it two ways. We'll do it your way, and we'll do it our way.
Yes.
So he made two Bills.
He made two?
He shot one take of the way that he wanted, and guess which one they used?
His way.
And then when the two boys that, I'm sorry, the writers, the brilliant writers, one is Barry, I forget the other man. When we were at the Emmys, we were all there at the Emmys, and when these guys got the Emmy for writing Bill, and this was inside stuff,
right.
But the writer got up, and the first thing he said with tears in his eyes is he says, because he had no idea he was going to win the Emmy for writing Bill. This was just a total shock. This is even before Dad got the Emmy for acting in it. He says, I want to thank Mickey Rooney for doing it his way.
That's right.
Huh? So he had to make two separate ones. A little. I mean, that's a little secret.
Elvis Presley.
Uh-huh.
Tell me about Elvis Presley, Mickey Rooney Jr.
What
a great man this is.
Tell him about Mom, the book.
Oh, yeah, we can.
Yeah.
Yes, go ahead.
It's kind of been a real ethereal kind of relationship I've had real early, because when Elvis really hit big, I was 9 years old.
Nine,
and he was 10 years older than I was, so he was 19.
Yeah, but you could appreciate him at nine.
But at nine years old, when I heard Hound Dog, that did it for me, as it did for every Elvis aficionado. But to make a long story short, over the years, with my mom being one of the great background singers of the 60s and the 70s, she literally sang probably on more of the jingles and hit records that were being made.
Did she really?
She was one of the three singers that sang on the original.
That's is BJ.
Uh-huh.
And she was,
That's
uh-huh.
Life with
yes.
Frank Sinatra. She
yes.
was one of the three girls on that. All of Ray Charles's chorus, the black Ray Charles
right,
singer.
Right, of course.
Of George on My Mind and Ruby and all those hits. But I mean, the list literally, she was the voice of Nancy Kwan in the movie The Flower Drum Song.
Great.
And there was a Marilyn Monroe show out a few years ago where I can't remember, Catherine, someone played Marilyn Monroe, but when she sang My Heart Belongs to Daddy and all of that, it was my mom's voice. So,
and literally done hundreds of commercials. I mean, when commercials were commercials and you could make a fortune doing it.
But not to get off the track to resolve about Elvis, she did a lot of Elvis's recordings. She was on a lot of his records. She has some very prized photographs of Elvis with her arms around my mom.
Does she have a book now, you say? Yeah,
she's working on
it. Well, it's a long story, but I got very close with... I got very close
wild,
with...
Really? A wild book.
With Elvis Presley's lead singer, Kathy Westmoreland, who was with Elvis for the last 8 years of Elvis's life. And she did literally 1,400 concerts as his lead vocalist. Well, I've known Kathy for a lot of years, and I have enticed. I solely was the
instigator,
the force behind her getting to off her little to write this book about Elvis. Because the fact of the matter was that the last 8 years of Elvis's life, he was in love with Kathy Westmoreland, and the world really does not know. They know it now. But we have the rights, our family has the rights to that book called Kathy and Elvis, which will be out for the 10th year anniversary of Elvis this August 16th.
But I got to tell you this, just as an enticement, and I don't mean to do this as a suspense thing, but Skippy, the things that we learned about this man and this relationship is literally going to blow minds. We are bound to secrecy until this book is published. Now, you're going to hear a lot about books. I mean, hey, you know, we're not telling any secrets.
Yes, yes,
I mean,
there's
a book out, there's a thing in People magazine right now.
The
daughters of Elvis and Desiree and all of that, and then in this book, this. But as I understand it from Kathy, this is going to put them all away.
Really?
Yeah, this
like
is
explosion.
Yeah, because the truth sometimes is when you really see it, like everybody's trying to get to the truth about anything. When the truth, it's either got to be so crazy in Arizotz that when you hear it, you say that's got to be crazy. It's either the truth or the biggest lie that ever hit.
Mickey Rooney Senior book. What's happening?
You mean the one from Knopf?
Yeah.
People have to realize that he is writing the book. He will not let anyone else write the book. No one ghosted his first book called I.E. I don't know if you know the book.
Yes, I do.
Okay.
Yes,
but,
I do.
But the latest book, now Arthur Marx wrote a book called The Nine Lives of Mickey Rooney.
Right.
I said you should have called it The Nine Wives of Mickey Rooney. It's just a joke.
I wed
eight wives.
You seem very happy.
I am a happy person.
Why are you happy? Why are you so happy?
I don't know, but you seem very happy, and I love it.
I don't know.
Your dad is right now at the Pantages.
Doing funny things happen on the forum.
Very good. And from there, where does it go, the show?
Well, I don't know. You don't